BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
This is the sound of a deer. It's from a YouTube video. People are calling them zombie deer. And watching it, this thing does actually look like something out of The Walking Dead. It's filmed from inside a car back in 2020. The driver's pulled up next to a crop field in rural America. And this deer does a kind of backflip. It rears up on its hind legs and then runs at the car, falls over, skids across the road. That's when the poor thing growls. The person who filmed it says it died soon after.
Ain't bad. You all right?
Across the United States, people are posting similar films after coming across deer walking in circles, finding them confused by the side of the road. Nobody filming knows exactly what's wrong with the deer. But in the comments, everyone's talking about one thing.
That's not a normal deer. It's actually a zombie. This deer has chronic wasting disease.
Chronic wasting disease. CWD. A deer prion disease. Just like mad cow disease and CJD. Let me tell you a story. It might sound familiar. There's a new brain disease in an animal, one that people eat. There's no evidence it can transfer to humans, but fears mounting that it might. And then, people start filling in the gaps left by scientists and politicians with speculation of a cover-up. Here we go again. I'm Lucy Proctor, and from BBC Radio 4, this is The Cows Are Mad. Episode 10, Zombie Deer.
Everyone will say you're crying wolf, you know, that this is not really real. But in fact, the day that you find it's real, it's too late.
The good thing about being an infectious disease expert sounding the alarm about a prion disease in 2023 is that history's on your side.
I'm Dr. Michael Osterholm. I direct the Center for Infectious Disease Research and Policy at the University of Minnesota.
Chronic wasting disease now affects
Michael Osterholm's been warning another mad cow disease could be on the horizon since 2019. Here he is talking to news station PBS. Americans say prions, by the way.
He joins us now from Minneapolis, and thanks very much for doing so.
Thank you. We have to take a brief snapshot of history and understand that back in 1986, when the first cows were showing to signs and symptoms, everyone around the world said, don't worry about it, there's a species barrier. This prion will not jump from animals to humans. And if you look at the conditions today for what's happening with chronic wasting disease in North America, very, very similar situation.
Chronic wasting disease first emerged in North America in the late 60s. It does the same to deer as other prion diseases do to cows and humans. The deer are confused, then unable to walk, then they die. Hapless deer management since the 1970s, with deer farmers moving stock around and infecting new herds and wild deer, along with a hunting lobby that downplayed the rates of infection for years, has led to what experts are calling a new epidemic. In some counties in America's Northwest, as many as 60% of deer are said to be infected with chronic wasting disease. It's in Northern Europe too, especially Norway. CWD is far more infectious than BSE. The rogue prions can transfer via saliva and deer droppings and can even be found in the roots and leaves of plants in deer-heavy regions. And so, the big question is what's going to happen to the 4% of Americans who hunt and then eat deer?
Can I say that we're going to actually see human-related CWD? I don't know. I wouldn't want to bet against it right now. We're now seeing new strains of the prion.
In initial research, mice injected with deer CWD didn't go on to develop a prion brain disease, still the main way to test if prion diseases can jump species.
Now today, the strains we're seeing as they've evolved over time, that is happening.
Canadian researchers recently saw the disease jump to macaques, which ate infected deer meat. In Minnesota, Dr. Osterholm's team is gaming out responses to various scenarios. They're mainly concerned about deer hunters, but other meat eaters too. There's a fear CWD could jump to pigs or cows, And there's also the possibility of cross-contamination at meat processors, despite testing of farmed deer. Colleagues in parks management and academia are trying to stop the spread, and hunters are being encouraged to test all their kills before eating any wild venison. But in a way, the genie might already be out of the bottle because of the prion disease time lag. Michael Osterholm has no compelling evidence CWD is going to jump species, including, maybe, to humans. But just like with the BSE crisis, confirmation will come with people dying. And by the time that happens, others may already be infected. Once again, nobody knows where CWD comes from. But there is, of course, a theory. And once again, sheep are in the dock.
And I'm actually looking right out my window right now, a little deer walking along, so it always cheers me up to see that.
Kent Webb runs a deer news site called deerfriendly.com.
I have these automated tools that do a daily internet search so people can keep, you know, up to date about what's going on.
His emeritus professor at San Jose State University in California, after teaching business and quantitative geography for 30 years, he got really into all things deer after moving to the oak forests of Silicon Valley, where the tech millionaires live. Some of the tech bros didn't like the deer. They saw them as a pest and wanted to cull them. Kent got involved in a local deer rescue and counter-cull campaign, and that's where he came across CWD and talk of a source for the epidemic.
I've seen some articles. There's one in the Wall Street Journal that said, this was about 2017, I think, more or less, that was saying, you know, all of the cases of chronic wasting disease could be traced back to Fort Collins, Colorado, where they do research on deer.
Tucked between the Rocky Mountains and the Great Plains, the town of Fort Collins is home to Colorado State University, a distinguished research university that often teams up with various government agencies. It's where CWD was first documented, and it's where, in the late 70s, it was confirmed as a prion disease. Kent Webb was intrigued and began tracing media reports of CWD, starting with the Wall Street Journal article and working backwards.
There was a fellow at Fort Collins, and he reported to the newspaper that when he was there, the deer that he was working with were being kept in pens where previously sheep were being fenced from a project where sheep had scrapie.
A sheep prion disease.
It was a local paper, and that article kind of got lost.
But Kent found the story republished in an agricultural magazine.
I have a copy of that original version. Anyway, as I went through my data, I found that for all 16 outbreaks between 1967 and 2007, you could either directly trace them back to Fort Collins, or you could trace them back to deer that had been traced back to Fort Collins.
After 2007, Kent says it became impossible to trace anything because CWD became too prevalent. The researchers at Colorado State University are skeptical the epidemic started with them. It could have come from other deer imported into the research facility, and they see the Fort Collins origin theory as urban legend. But the link to a research centre that's also linked to the government's park service and other state research bodies added a conspiratorial tone to things when Kent published his work in 2021.
I noticed that within about a week I got an email from a professor in China. You know, there's a little bit of a comparison to the COVID-19. You know, the government agencies maybe in China don't want to talk about the origin. You know, here in the United States, it seems like the government agencies are a little biased toward the theory that we don't really know what the origin is.
We know by now that there are limits to what science can tell us about prion diseases. And when there's a mystery about where a killer disease has come from, people start to fill in the gaps with homegrown theories and alternative facts. Here's rock star turned political activist and hunting advocate Ted Nugent speaking on the Joe Rogan podcast.
Believe me when I tell you, the CWD hysteria is a scam.
Joe Rogan's covered CWD quite a bit. He's a hunter himself, and a definite believer that CWD is real, by the way. He also invited Dr. Michael Osterholm onto his show in February last year.
You and I were talking earlier about the potential for chronic wasting disease to be a problem for humans.
The chronic wasting one really scares me because there's so many people that have a vested interest in dismissing it. But if you see what it's doing to deer, it's terrifying.
Then there's another group. There are no documented cases of CWD jumping species yet. But scroll through the comment sections on YouTube videos on CWD and you'll find hunting families convinced the CJD in their loved ones has been caused by eating infected deer. The human form of CJD can occur naturally, but these people are talking of a cover-up. They'll never know for sure, just like Christine Lord, who told us about her son Andrew, who died aged just 24 back in 2007 from the human form of BSE. Christine's still searching for answers about the exact source of mad cow disease, or the exact route of infection for humans, about what exactly killed Andrew. She's convinced somebody knows more than they're prepared to say in public. But she also wants everyone to be more aware of the dangers of zoonotic diseases, diseases that can jump species.
BSE is a zoonotic disease, the harbinger of COVID and the next pandemics. And the World Health Organization say that there are so many emerging zoonotic diseases now because of our encroachment of wildlife. So when I looked into BSE and when I investigate it and continue to investigate it, I was very aware that it will happen again.
Chronic wasting disease might not be the next human prion disease. We won't know until we know. If it were to emerge in human form, it wouldn't be on the scale of BSE. Beef is much more widely consumed. But these rogue prions are out there. They haven't gone away. And they're perfect for our paranoid times. Deadly, practically indestructible, and really hard to properly understand, with a slow incubation period that's just right for cultivating fear and speculation. In some corners of the internet, some people are convinced COVID-19 is a prion disease, just like BSE. Others are convinced the COVID vaccine is causing new prion diseases. They've got the science wrong, but these ideas are gaining ground. And the thing is, now, we can see all this speculation happening in real time, online. The citizen investigators and dissident scientists of the 90s were a dedicated but small bunch, and they existed in isolated bubbles. There'd be newspaper articles, or sometimes TV documentaries, about some of the stranger sides of the mad cow story. And the confusion about whether beef was safe permeated society. But it was all quite contained. Today, not only have we still got these indestructible infectious prions and the knowledge gaps in what science can tell us about where these diseases come from, now we're all connected digitally all the time. All sorts of theories, credible or not, spread far and fast. I think it's only going to get more mad. The Cows Are Mad is written and produced by me, Lucy Proctor. Sound design and mix by James Beard. The editor is Richard Fenton Smith. Original music by Pete Cunningham. Additional editorial advice from Roger Marney. Production support from Gemma Ashman and Janet Staples. The commissioning editor for Radio 4 is Dan Clark. Thanks for listening.
I'm John Sudworth, and this is the story of my quest to ask a question.
No interview for rentals.
You have no right to tell me not to ask questions.
It's one that's become embroiled in the fractious and fevered politics of our times.
It's very dangerous to stir up suspicion, rumors.
It's not racist at all, no, not at all. It comes from China.
But it's a question that matters. Where did COVID come from? Fever, the hunt for COVID's origin, from BBC Radio 4. Listen and subscribe on BBC Sounds.